got me loose. Ain't no use of holding tongue, it's on the run. Slurring words, it's got a mind of its own. When I'm on one, when I'm on one, I'm really on one, I'm really on one. I got a limo by my eyes, put that milkshake in my face. Girl, we fucking right away. Lick your lips, girl, that's my taste. When I'm on one, when I'm on one, I'm really on one.
Listening to IBNX. IBNXradio.com.
Hey, what's up? It's your girl, Ms. Poison Ivy, and I'm here with my fantastic co-host.
Yes, sir. Only one tippy. I'm fantastic.
Yes, you are.
Oh, that's the first time I heard that.
I don't hang with anything less.
I ain't mad at you.
We are here for No Filter Fridays. Yeah. Welcome, welcome. This is our first official show of 2020.
Well, not really, because we brought in the new year.
No, but that doesn't count.
That was like a no filter new year.
It was, but like this is the first Friday show.
Gotcha. True.
So this is the first Friday show of the new year. And we just...
I'm excited.
Are you?
I'm ready to drink this Pueblo Viejo Armacato de los Santos.
So first of all... I told you I need you to put some pep in your step because the little intro was playing and I was just like vibing and twerking by myself.
You're going to be twerking by yourself every time too.
Well, wait, listen. Twerk. See, you don't even hear it. Oh.
I don't hear it, but I ain't finna twerk right now though. I do the robot for you.
There you That's go. It. Wait.
Here. I give you the robot.
Get on the beat.
I can't hear it.
No, I'm just kidding.
We're going to put you in the dance competition.
Oh, and I will win. Let me tell you.
Do it for Lil Saint right quick.
So, first of all.
Do it for Lil Saint.
Wait, listen. No. Oh. So, you know, I in a former life, I actually did dance. I was very good at it. And I actually used to coach a high school dance squad.
We're in Atlanta and dancing. It ain't Broadway. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, I have hit a pole a time or two, but not for money. For fun. But I ballet, jazz, tap, African.
A real dancer.
Modern hip-hop. Yes, a real dancer.
Okay, because when you say you danced in Atlanta, you're like, which club?
No, so I used to actually coach a high school dance squad.
Okay.
And I used to tell those girls, if you can't outdance me, you cannot perform at the game on the weekend. Mm. So, like, in practice, I would make up all the choreography. And it would be interesting because, first of all, when I was in high school, our dance squad, we made up our choreography. Our coach said on the side, just as an adult being there. These girls, they're as lazy as hell. Like, yeah, they looking at me like, you ain't make up no dance? So I had to choreograph, like, all the dances. So I would, like, watch videos and, like, pull.
I was going to ask you, was you watching, what was that lady name that used to do a lot of Diddy videos? Lady, you know what I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to her. She was dope.
So it was a couple of them. It was Big Les.
That's her name?
Yeah, with the thick thighs.
Yeah.
No, she had thick thighs and big butt.
Yes, sir.
That's why they called her Big Les. But no, first of all, Big Les was like big when we were in high school.
You said Big Legs?
Les.
Oh.
Her name was like Leslie. Her name was like Leslie or something like that.
Okay.
But it could have been Legs because her legs was, she had thick thighs.
Right.
But no, this was way after that. So I was watching like Beyonce videos and different stuff and pulling pieces. So the girls would be like so excited when I would come teach a dance because they're like, oh my God, that's from the video that just came out this weekend. I'm like, yeah, I'm on it. And so, but I would like, I was grown, like in my late 20s telling them like, if you can't outdance me, you can't perform.
Yeah, I could have helped y'all.
They never could outdance me.
I could have helped you with some of the moves.
I'm pretty sure.
I used to watch all the Usher videos back in the day. That make You Make Me Wanna. What?
That's too slow.
What?
Too
slow. I knew the whole routine.
But it's too slow.
I knew that's the only dance I could probably do.
We might have could. You know what? We probably could have used some of that. Because I did do one routine to a Britney Spears song where I had them do some breakdance moves.
You lost me. Britney Spears?
Britney Spears was jamming.
Oops, I did it again, Britney Spears?
No, like Circus.
Toxic. Oh, Circus. Okay.
Britney
okay.
Spears. Yes.
Okay.
Faster, like
yeah.
older, grown Britney Spears.
You know, I still don't even know how to do the electric slide. That shit is like solving a Rubik's Cube.
Dude. I don't know if you can come to the cookout.
Two left feet. I sit down. I just sit in my.
No.
I sit and I make my.
You have to know how to do the electric slide coming to the cookout.
And I put my plate on my legs and I just eat.
No.
Is it?
First of all, if
I don't play. Listen, I'm halfway black. I don't play spades. I don't do no electric slide. Oh, nobody, y'all too violent.
We need to go to a commercial.
No.
We just got to go to commercial and I'll be back with a new co-host. After
violent,
this,
man.
Tippy.
Listen.
We just got married and we finna get divorced already.
Man, listen.
Cause how?
I can't do it.
Those watching us on camera, you see, I'm just
you can't tell me spades don't get violent.
Not if you really know how to play.
Which I don't.
The trash talk. Violent. No, the trash talk. Should be enough.
Man,
cause see me,
time for that, man. You trying to get me to serve 10 years now?
Me, I'm gonna whoop you, and then talk trash after I beat you. While you talk trash during the game, thinking you doing something, I'm the silent assassin.
Well, we're gonna have an episode where you teach me how to play spades.
I will
really don't
never.
Know how to play.
I will never. You're too grown and too old. If you didn't learn as a teenager, it's over.
Man, listen. Y'all want some pressure and I declare war? What's happening? I got you. I'm
really?
The king.
Really? Try Peak Solitaire one time.
What do they call that? Not Blackjack. What's the other one? Where you at? Tonk. I'm the king of Tonk.
You don't even know the name of the game. How you the king?
I declare war and Tonk.
I think you might be a prince.
Got you.
Mm-mm. We have to bring some cards out just to prove the point.
It's not easy dealing with black people in spades at a barbecue.
First of all, you already are not coming to the barbecue because you can't do the electric slide. When the
if
electric,
I bring some napkins and some sodas, I'm coming.
First of all,
and I'm taking the gold plates.
First of all, the
I got
fact that you think that napkins and soda is enough, you bring napkins. You got to bring
I'm
napkins.
I'm bringing Tupperware containers too.
You got to bring napkins, plates, and cups and sodas. You can't just bring one or two of those.
See, that
you
barbecue
bring
is too ghetto. I go to the, like, slightly white barbecue where it's, like, they have all the amenities, but you still bring something just to bring it, and you just take it back to the car. Oh, shit, y'all got napkins.
You
I
take
bring
it
back.
Back
to the car.
No.
I'm going to bring
now
back
see,
my Tupperware containers.
Now, see, that's too ghetto. You don't go to nobody's cookout or party and then take your shit back because it didn't get opened.
Well.
Who does that?
Well.
Who raised you people?
Well. Hello, family.
You know what?
Shout out to my family.
I really need to have a talk with Tippy's family because I got some concerns.
Nah, seriously, though, shout out to my family. They are in town right now for my little cousin Dior's gymnastic. What do they call that? Like the little
competition?
Yeah, gymnastics competition. So shout out to Dior, my little cousin. Love you, LeVar, Kenesha, whole family up here.
Shout out to
love
the
y'all.
Only One Tippy family.
That ain't teach me how to play spades.
Or electric slide. Or none of the things that real black people know how to do. Because, even, listen.
I know how to smoke.
Your family didn't teach you that.
Don't speak to. You don't know that.
Family.
You don't know that.
Family.
I got some cousins.
It's always the cousins.
All my cousins taught me.
Tony, we going to go to the store.
Oh, we went to the store, all right.
And you know what y'all doing on the way
we
to the store
down,
or on the way back from the
fighting.
Store?
Back in the day, it was fighting, but now it's going to go get the munchie food and smoking on the way down the way back.
But listen, okay, so here's the rules.
Mm-hmm. What, for the black barbecue?
Yes, that you were violating. And we got to discuss this because the summer is coming up in a few months and you're going to have to get your life right.
All right, talk to me.
So number one, everybody does at least one line dance at the black barbecue. It don't matter who the dude is, the hardest dude. He either electric sliding, cha-cha sliding, wobbling, something.
No.
But you got to do one of the above. So we're going to make sure that you learn one of those
okay.
before the barbecue this summer.
Okay, I got a question. I thought the number one rule of the black barbecue is do not bring the girl who's not really your girlfriend. You know what I'm saying?
No,
I
nobody.
That was the number one rule.
No. So here's the thing.
Because I'm in a family full of women.
Right.
So you understand where I'm coming from, right?
Right. So let me explain to you how that works. Around. Okay. So you can bring a random if she's your friend.
Okay.
Okay? Because the family will embrace your friend like she is family. Like,
but you know I ain't finna bring no friends to the barbecue.
So like my best guy friend, he just hit me the other day. His sister is turning 40 and she's having a big thing. And she even hit him and like, hey, make sure you invite Poison Ivy. Now, I go to family stuff. I'm not his girl, but I'm the friend. So it's okay.
But I'm talking about when y'all are intimate.
No, you don't bring her because everybody's going to judge her for a number of things. So number one, we looking at her crazy if she don't get up and fix your plate. Because at the end of the day, she your chick. And she done came to the barbecue.
But what if she put the wrong stuff on the plate?
Then that means you didn't know her well enough to bring her to the barbecue in the first place.
What if she was hungry?
Then
I'm
you
trying
should
to help her sister out, man.
No.
I eat later.
No, because we all judge her. And then you better watch what the hell she got on. Because if she show up looking like a trollop, a skank, a scooch, a scallywag, a skunt,
a thot,
any of the above, we're going to talk about her the whole time. We're going to be sitting over on the side, sipping either tea, lemonade, or some other mixed beverage, judging her thot ass. Because who the hell show up to somebody's family barbecue the first time in front of their grandma dressed like a hoe? And I don't know where she thought she was going in that short-ass dress with that big butt.
Life, that's all I used to deal with.
And we talked, and they were talking about her.
And my family know that.
But were they talking about her? Yes.
You know what? I've never been that type of guy to bring women around my family members. Because like I said, I'm in a family full of women, and it doesn't go well for them.
Right.
In their face. Because, not when she leave.
Because why? This our family event. You a guest.
Yeah, but my family would do that shit in their house. My family, like, they with the shits.
Yeah. Because this family.
Yeah.
See, you got to learn the rules. I'm going to have you right for this summer, for the family cookout this summer. Because first of all, don't take no chick.
Ain't invite no thoughts.
No. Don't take no chick that's not just a friend.
Right.
Unless you ready for her to have to see all the craziness that comes with your family.
Right.
And I say that because you're going to scare her the hell off before you even really sealed the deal.
Okay. I can. Well, my crazy part of my family is in Miami, so that's a good. Well, no.
Don't tell a lie.
That's a lie.
Tell the truth. Shame the devil.
Yep, they everywhere.
See?
You're right.
I am now older cousin status.
And this is why I bring Tupperware. See, everything come back full circle. This is why I bring Tupperware containers to the barbecue.
And we all talking about you. Listen, he done brought that hoe up in here.
I ain't bring her. I brought Tupperware containers to take it back to her.
Yeah. Oh, so this hoe thinks she too good to come to the family barbecue, but you think you finna take this food to her?
I can't win. I'm going to eat it on the way to the house anyway.
No, we still judging. We judging. Because what, she thinks she too good? She can't come hang out with the family? She can't come meet us? Who this whole thing she is?
So you can't win regardless, right?
You can.
Because she will be.
Because she stayed her thot ass at home. Because she knew.
If she's in my front seat, she
we know. First of all, we know what he deal with. And we try.
Hold on.
I was about to add a caveat.
In my past life.
I was about to add something.
Okay.
We know what he usually deal with. And we're trying to get him to be better. He got a couple of prospects. But he knew not to bring him around here yet till he sealed the deal.
Got to vet him.
But if he got to take her a plate, we know she a hoe. What
no, she's going to be a hoe.
See?
But, see? The ones I invite. No. She would have been a hoe in 2019. Let me say that because I don't deal with hoes no more. I left him in 2019. So,
let me see
she comes.
Let me see your contacts.
Let me flip that phone upside down. Put that down right now. Matter of fact, I'm putting my phone over here. All right. So, anyway.
Uh-huh.
I left them all in 2019. All the hoes. I do have some women, and this is on Facebook. I know some of them probably watching, but not
some
the
hoes.
Not the hoes. The prospects. So, bae.
Prospect hoes.
No, prospect women, prospect girlfriend. I'm going into
this year. So, you're talking about the desirables maybe watching.
Right. Mm-hmm. I'm going into this year a new person. Mm-hmm. I'm going into this year with a new mindset.
Going into the year a month in, but go ahead.
I'm going into this year. It was a long year so far.
I'm going to say January was a long year.
I'm going in this full force, though, but I really want to do the right thing. Oh, some comments? Oh,
we got comments? What? Wait, what? Tell me from who? Where?
Can y'all hear me out there?
Yeah.
Yes.
Facebook.
We got comments.
All
okay. Right.
Well, somebody said that this is current life, that this is all lies.
Said that. Woo! Who said that? Hold on. Let me flip this phone back over. Woo! Who said that? What's the name on it?
The truth shall set ye free.
What's the name on that? Who said it?
Let me just say this.
Hold on. I'm going to call y'all because I'm going to jump on this.
Let me just say this.
I don't see nothing.
And I'm going to give it a thought pop because that's what he used to the thought pops.
Oh, that's my cut. Oh, wow. Really, cuz? You're really going to do that to me?
Thank you. Because I'm speaking for the family because I'm telling you. I know this dude right here. He going to come up this summer trying to. And the sad thing is he going to have a sweet, wholesome, good prospect somewhere. But that ain't who he bringing to the goddamn cookout. He gonna bring the hoe. And please let me go too so I can sit with the family and talk about her hoe ass.
She is not gonna be a hoe. I left them in 2019. The last time I
Cousin Myra said
hoe,
you lying.
The last time I went to a barbecue with a hoe, that
she
was
said,
in 2019.
Cousin Myra said you a lie and a cheat and the truth ain't in you.
I was. We change.
We don't believe you.
Thank God.
You need more people.
We don't believe you. Listen. Sometimes your past could dictate your future. Well, some people see you in your past. They'll put that on you in your future. You understand?
Is that what happened?
I'm a great man now. Listen, I'm going to leave it at that.
Yes.
When we going to pop open this Hoble Cuervo Heterosexual Soul?
So we're going to take a quick break. You're listening to No Filter Fridays on IBNX Radio with only one Tippy.
Yeah.
And Ms. Poison Ivy.
Yes,
we
sir.
Will be right back.
Friends will start to abandon their religions and believe in themselves. And the new world order will start.
Drop that motherfucker!
Narcissistic, insufficient, that weight I've been searching. Black eyes coexisting, just don't seem to work with other bitches. It's black and white when dark and night, that's when I do my searching. Ain't the anti-crisis in my mind, the evolution's lurking.
I got voices in my head, wild horses in my head, running around. Hearts playing, breaking parts up in my head, waking corpses in my head. Neighbors better off dead, running faucets in my head, stomping, marching in my head. Sun is scorching in my head, Archie Bunkers in my head, talking bunkers in my head. Willy Wonka's in my head, all this junk is in my head. Then it's sunk into my head. Little monkeys in my head, going bananas in my head, shooting cannons in my head, hitting targets in my head, playing pianos in my head, keyboards, organs in my head, smash guitars in my head, fast cars in my head with loud ass horns in my head, horns sticking out my head.
I can't get the fuck out my head. I can't get the fuck out my head. I can't
get the fuck out my head. I can't.
I can't get the fuck out my head. I can't get the fuck out my head. I can't get the fuck out my head. I can't get the fuck out my head.
All these voices in my head, they're committing arson in my head. World wars up in my head. Crash courses in my head. Fighting forces in my head. White noises sounding red.
All these voices in my head. All these thoughts up in my head. Like a spark plug in my head. Like a touch up in my head. Ain't no shockers in my head. All these shocks up in my head. All these shocks need to be fed.
Baby had a motherfucker for his contest. Take the bodies. Can't see the devil
Get the fuck out of my head. I can't. Get the fuck out of my head. I can't. Get the fuck out of my head. I can't. Get the fuck out of my head.
You're listening to IBNX. IBNXradio.com.
All right, we're back. You're listening to No Filter Fridays right here on IBNXradio.com.
With only one tippy and Miss Poison Ivy.
Thank you.
There you go.
So, we have gotten to
my favorite part of the show.
It's usually my favorite part too, but I don't know what the hell's gonna be tonight. And this is the drink of the night. Dun, dun, dun,
dun. Dun, 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 dun. So y'all know my frugal cheap ass.
Wait, we gotta explain what it is first.
Okay.
So the drink of the night is basically a point where we select a random ass drink and we drink it.
Random affordable drink.
Sometimes.
Right. So today,
because 2020, I'm getting flued out all year. So
on
I might get flued out by somebody with some money, and then it might be an expensive drink that I bring or something like that.
Bring that 1942? Well, this is probably 2008. If that's 1942. But nonetheless, it was my turn to bring a drink. Yeah. And I am honored to be able to do the first one. So we have Pueblo Viejo. Hold on, how you say that? Viejo?
Viejo. Viejo.
Pueblo Viejo, which is Jose Cuervo's uncle, Pepe Lopez's cousin, and Patron's daddy.
So let's just be very clear.
This is a drunk uncle. This is a drunk Spanish uncle.
So let's be very clear that Jose is not my friend. I do not like that dude. I do not fuck
with
him.
Why don't you like
Jose? Listen, this dude tried to attack me one time, and I just do not fool with him.
Do you like Don Julio? Have you tried Don Julio?
Me and Don can hang occasionally, but me and Jose?
Yeah. Jose's the bad cousin. This like the drunk uncle.
I don't fool with Jose. So I don't know what
he cool.
Pueblo is about to be about.
He blanco. He cool.
This sound like the broke drunk uncle.
He cool. His middle name Agave. His middle. Well, you know what? It's kind of like Cuervo.
No.
Like Pueblo. So his full name is Tequila Pueblo Viejo.
I don't buy it.
Anybody with the last name Viejo, they good people. Tap the bottle. Tap it. We still do it. Yeah. All drunks do that. Listen, y'all.
I've never done that in my life.
I ain't gonna lie to you since.
I don't know what's happening.
Ever since New Year's, right? We had 1800.
Yes, we did.
I had about 30 shots.
We had lots of 1800.
A lot of it. And I woke up feeling great. So ever since the New Year. And I've got drunk a few times since then.
Let's be very clear about those shots, though.
I've been on tequila.
You poured every one of those trouble for yourself.
No.
Yes, you did.
No. I would
except
leave.
Except the first one.
I would walk off because, you know what I'm saying? Like, I hit a door and somebody knocking at the door. I go check the door. I got a whole another shot filled up. And I'm like, man, y'all got to stop this.
So let's be very clear about a couple of things. Anybody watching, listening, whatever. Number one, there was nobody at the damn door. Okay? The whole time we was here, it was the same people in here that started the night out. So anytime somebody got up to go to the door, which was only him. I don't know what he was hearing. Nobody was knocking. Nobody was here.
It was a drunk Uncle Pueblo at the front door like, let me in, bro. Y'all got 1800?
This is the crazy thing.
This is 1886. Look at that.
Dude would come.
1872 what?
Look, we had these shot glasses that came with the bottle of 1800.
Mm-hmm.
So he's drinking out of one. I'm drinking out of one. We had two more people drinking out of them.
And they had Jose. No, they came with Bacardi, right?
They had Bacardi.
Bacardi.
He would pour his shot, then get up and I guess go answer the door. And then come back and say, y'all pour me another shot.
I remember no such thing.
And we would be like, no, you poured that yourself. Nah, y'all poured this shot.
I remember no such thing.
Sit there for a minute,
pour another shot and go answer the door. And we would look at each other like, he gonna come back and blame us for this shot. I was pushing the bottle away like, y'all, he gonna keep thinking it's me. And he's pouring this himself. Like, it's crazy.
Y'all see why people be like, I ain't pouring no shots. Yeah. I don't pour my own shots.
Look at you now. So, I said all that to say.
It's water.
It was his turn. His turn for the drink of the night.
And we got...
Why did he show up with this?
No.
Let's be very clear.
He was calling my name.
With just this.
He was calling my name.
And what else did you have to go with that?
He said, listen, I was walking down the aisle, right? I stopped at a random liquor store today because I was just out on the west side of Atlanta.
And that's the best way to find the liquor for the drink of the night. Random.
Right. I literally randomly stopped there, so I said, "Scoot," you know what I feel me? I pulled in, right? And I'm walking up and down the aisles, and I'm like, what should we drink tonight? And I hear somebody say, "Tippy." What the
fuck? Wait, you heard somebody say what?
Tippy. So I'm looking around the store, I'm like, okay, I am a semi-celebrity, you feel me? Somebody might know me. So I'm looking around the store. Ain't nobody there. No, I'm stacking shit on the shelf. I'm like, couldn't have been him. I'm still looking. Tippy. What the fuck is going on? So I look towards the shelf and I'm like,
okay.
You know, energy. So I kind of, I did like this. That motherfucker said, Tippy. Oh my God. I got to get him. I got to get Pueblo. And this is how we.
So Uncle Pueblo was calling your name.
He was calling me. I swear for Lord, he was calling me.
So, Tippy shows up with Uncle Pueblo.
Yes.
And nothing else except...
beer salt. Shout out to my sister Ebony. She got me this beer salt. I just be eating this.
Beer salt? Yeah. What the... What are we supposed to do with this?
You're supposed to chase it with the salt.
No.
Tequila. Tequila is... People, please comment on Facebook, wherever you at. Are you supposed to chase tequila, or do you drink it with beer salt? Salt, period.
I'm like, do you want to spend the night at the damn radio station? Because that's what's going to happen if we drink this with beer salt.
Yeah, you're supposed to.
But I'm not going to lie.
I'm drinking out of core.
I'm not going to lie. I'm no better because what I got was...
Red Bull. Which is going to give us wings.
To go with... Uncle Pueblo. Because I feel like Uncle Pueblo is going to knock us down. And we need the Red Bull.
Nah, Pueblo
to
good.
Give us some wings.
He good people.
So.
A little bit more.
Hold that's on. Two shots in there.
No, that's a whole shot. Let me pour yours. Like you was doing me that night.
Come on. You're such a liar.
Come on. What you got in there?
Red Bull.
Oh.
Okay, that's good. Damn it.
Sorry. Have a heavy day.
See?
You tried it?
It's so strong. I smell it.
All right. So, Pueblo, Jose, all y'all, Patron, all y'all in the family.
Then he didn't bring no cups. I don't know what he thought he was going to drink out of. Man, I had this cup in my car.
Listen, one thing y'all going to learn about me, I am ghetto.
Clearly. I don't think this is what Core had in mind.
Well, hey. Hey.
Did you pour the beer salt on your hand?
Yeah, I did. You ready? Salud. Salud.
We can't see that.
Oh, scrum. Oh.
What the hell?
Woo.
Just ball it up and throw it over here.
Yeah. Shout out to Pueblo.
Some of us are going to sip our troubles.
Shout out to my amigos. Shout out to Pueblo.
No.
Shout out to...
all the other drunk uncles.
Yeah.
I don't know. You look like you got a little hair on your chest. I can't taste it. The Red Bull is...
That's why you're supposed to do shots.
No.
You at least got to do one shot. The way you taste the liquor.
I don't have nothing to pour it into. Sorry.
Man, dry the boat. Hold your head back. Hold your head back.
Y'all hear that shit?
We finna dry the boat. Hold your head back. Hold your head back.
I have never in my life driven a boat.
Hold your head back like that.
Who? First of all, let's discuss this.
Hold your head back.
Why is this called driving the boat?
I don't know.
Because clearly I'm not driving if you pouring it down my throat.
I don't know, but you about to drown in the boat.
We can't see that.
I'm blind. You don't want to see me squint.
The light is bottled up and throw it to us.
I'm squinting like a mother. Y'all don't want
to
see
our engineer is trying to write us a note.
Hold on, y'all.
And we can't see it. There's a bright ass light shining in our face. And no.
Oh. Stay away from the F word.
Oh.
Tasha.
She knows I don't have no filter. The f- I'm just kidding.
Freak, man.
I was about to say the fuck.
Oh, dry the boat.
Dude.
You got to dry the boat. I'm going to pour half a shot. It ain't even going to be a full shot.
I don't want you to mess up my sweatshirt.
Try the beer salt. The beer salt is good.
Okay, I'm going to take my sweatshirt off. Right. But I got to turn this way because I got a work shirt under me.
Hey, y'all. Hey, they're about to turn. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Y'all hit that premium subscribe button. She'll turn around for you. You did. You did. Just go ahead and hit
that. Hey, why you trying to play me like I got an OnlyFans?
Go ahead and hit that donation button. And
oh, you took me off?
No, okay. Put it back on. Put it back on once they hit that donate button. We will put her back on the camera. Have her turn around slowly with Pueblo.
Okay. You ready?
Yeah.
I've never done this.
We're gonna
drive the boat. Is this on the camera?
Yeah, it gotta be. We're finna drive the boat. Vroom, vroom, motherfucker.
Oh my god.
Ready?
You might not spill nothing on my shirt.
I got you.
Look, you see why I couldn't?
Okay, got you. Yeah. It's not. Yeah.
That's not appropriate.
You ready?
Don't pour a lot.
Wait, what radio show y'all know do this? We driving boats over here, okay, y'all. Yachts, boats.
How do you do that. The beer salt?
All right, so lick your hand, sort of stick. Lick your hand and pour it on your hand. There you go.
I feel like I need more.
It's probably going to be the longest segment of the day. Believe that.
Because I've never driven a damn boat. First of all, I'm not even driving. I feel like I'm riding.
I'm
driving. In the boat. You're driving the boat.
I'm driving, but I'm going to let you steer for a little bit.
I'm not going to be steering. I feel like...
You steering is pointed down your throat.
Right. You're driving and steering the boat.
This the boat.
Right. And then I'm just going to be like falling over the side of the boat.
No,
like,
the liquid is the boat.
Is that not what's going to happen?
Yep.
Like,
you ready?
Do you all see the terror in my face?
Ready?
I'm like, no. Okay. Wait, don't mess up my shirt.
One, I'm not. Yeah. Okay. I'm taking you back on camera. She drove that boat.
Woo.
Well, I would like to thank y'all.
Show's over.
For tuning in to Drink of the Day. But seriously, it's not bad. Pueblo Viejo, Enrique Iglesias, I give you let's say a siete. I give you a siete, man. What do you give him? I don't know. Siete, ocho, seven.
Seven. He gave it a seven.
On the scale of uno to diez, you get siete. Seven.
So I personally do not give it a seven.
What do you give it? You got to say it in Spanish, though.
Because of the beer salt.
You ain't like the beer salt?
Mm-mm.
I put that on my shrimp the other day. It's lemon lime. It's lemon lime beer salt.
Why?
Why not?
It's disgusting. It's like super salt.
Listen, I used to be sitting up there with my sister at 3 o'clock in the morning eating beer salt in the kitchen like this.
So.
You want to try the boat right quick?
All right, you ready? If it wasn't for the beer salt, I would give it a six. A six.
Six, okay.
Yes, you ready?
Driving the boat, yep.
Driving the boat, driving the boat, driving the boat, driving the boat. Okay. Ooh, sorry.
Barely gave me any. But it's cool. It's cool.
I gave him a shot's worth.
That wasn't no shot.
Yes.
Half of it ran down my face.
You had like two drops on your chin.
Two more drops I could have been drinking.
You know what? See?
Rashad,
this is exactly how New Year started. This is, I can't make this shit up.
But how it ended was worse. 30 shots later. What they said on SpongeBob, 30 shots later.
First of all, let's just be very clear. For anybody who got text or called New Year, we tried. We tried to stop him. We genuinely did. But at some point, the rest of us went to sleep and it was over. And we just kept hearing him, hey.
You're right.
Happy New Year.
You're right. I want to send out an apology, a formal apology to everyone.
Everyone.
I text, call, FaceTime while I'm drunk, and none of y'all answered.
Because it was like 4 in the fucking
morning. It don't matter. It don't matter.
Okay, seriously. We gotta talk about this.
What'd I do?
No. About me and my potty mouth.
Ain't no wrong with it.
This is no filter Fridays. However, I'm being filtered.
And the more Pueblo you get in your system, you're going to be saying a lot more words.
I'm not allowed to say 2 words.
You're going to be... Okay, I know it's the F word and the P word, right?
Yes, and the P word.
Man, that's like one of my favorite words.
Now, let me tell you... I'm going to tell you what I did one time.
On that too.
And she was so mad. But I had to do it. I know. And look, I still apologize to this day because she was real nice about it. But she was like, really?
Don't do that again.
So... We were doing like one of those like marathons on the station.
Yes.
And this is when we were at the first station. And I was engineering my own show. And she wasn't there. Mm-hmm. See? You see him. Pueblo. At some point he gonna start saying I'm still pouring shots down his throat.
Pueblo, my uncle.
So I was engineering my own show.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I was doing a tribute to Eazy-E.
Okay.
And I started playing Eazy-E Automobile.
Okay.
And at the end of that song, Eazy-E sings over and over again. All I want is the P. All I want is the P, 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 P. Like.
Wow. Okay.
I swear to God. And she, my phone was blowing up. She was like.
All right, Eazy-E. Okay. We shall refrain from those words.
I know, but I just could not resist because it was like Eazy-E's birthday or it was something like that, like his anniversary. And I had just been playing all this N.W.A. and this Eazy-E. And that's one of my favorite Eazy-E songs because it's really funny because they're like singing like it's just funny.
And speaking of anniversaries. We got to show love to a death anniversary today, the Big Pun. Today is 20 years he's been gone.
You know what? That seems so crazy because it just seemed like it was yesterday that happened. And, you know.
2000, I was in ninth grade. And I remember, I think the news broke on like MTV News or something like that when they used to do like the breaking news on MTV.
You see my face?
I remember that. What?
The ninth grade.
I was in the ninth grade around 2000. You know what I'm saying?
I ain't gonna tell you where I was.
Whole family.
I ain't got a family now. How I had a whole family then? Really? You just gonna try to play me?
I got a whole family at 19.
No. I was grown. I wasn't grown.
But you was out there.
But I was the house. I was grown. Yes. Funny thing is, though, I genuinely believe... The Fat Joe had Big Pun killed.
How? When he was overweight, he died from complications of breathing.
See? That's how it was easy to make you believe that.
Okay.
But if it
smothered him.
Big Pun had the career, not Fat Joe. Yeah, nobody was checking for Fat Joe until Big Pun died.
You feel that? I mean, I hope it's not, but, you know, rest in peace to Pun. You he was what? Amazing.
I tell you about all kind of hip hop conspiracies that's true that nobody will ever believe. How Jay-Z got rid of Biggie and Tupac so he could do his thing.
I mean, I heard somebody saying that if Big and Pac were still here, that a lot of artists wouldn't be where they are, even here, which is not true because it's evolution. The game evolves regardless
it of does, who's in it. But think about this. Jay-Z was around and out at that time, but wasn't nobody checking for Jay-Z?
What, when, 96? When did Reasonable Doubt come out? Let me look that up. 96? Okay, well.
But nobody was really paying him no attention like that. You got to think at the time, everybody was paying attention to Biggie, Tupac, and Nas.
Right.
Nas just was doing it because Nas was cute. And it was really us ladies who was just like, he's so fine.
Okay.
Same thing with Tupac. But Tupac was also like vocal and a thug and dudes like that. And then Biggie had the, like, you know,
the lyrics, the swag,
the lyrics. Yeah. He was the ladies' man. Yeah. But wasn't nobody really, really checking for Jay? That's why even Nas talk about him with the Hawaiian Sophie fame and the Hawaiian shirts and shit. But nobody checking for that.
Yeah, because he was with Jazz.
Yeah. No. You was the back dude. But, get rid of Biggie and Tupac. And then push Nas a little bit to the side. Less competition. Mm. Just like Beyonce got rid of Aaliyah.
Oh, I don't want to hear that. I can't, man. That's the Pablo talking.
No, I'll tell you this. I love Aaliyah, before man. Pablo.
I love Aaliyah. I love Beyonce.
Because think about this.
They're both amazing.
Who was the movie star? Who had the bigger hits? As soon as she was gone, she just... Aaliyah would have been in Fighting Temptations, I'm telling you.
Maybe she shouldn't have been in that movie because, I mean...
No, Beyonce was in it.
I know it. It wasn't a good movie.
Because Beyonce was in it. Beyonce's not a good actress.
She is. She.
No, she's the same character. What was that? I just really...
Carmen. No. The hip-hop opera, I really liked that. With Mekhi Phifer, that was...
You really liked it, but she wasn't good in it. Mekhi Phifer was good in it. Everybody else was good in it. She can sing, so she was okay.
Dreamgirls. Nope. She killed it.
No, she didn't.
She did her thing.
No, she didn't.
She did her thing. What was the other movie she was in? Cadillac?
Yep.
Pink, what? Oh, I didn't see that. I didn't see Pink Panther.
You didn't miss anything. She's the same character. Same monotone character. And don't get me wrong, I will fight you about Beyonce. Mm-hmm. So for me to say this is huge.
I got you.
I'll fight you about Lil' Kim.
Oh, I wouldn't be fighting over Lil' Kim.
I will fight you for the Queen Bee.
She the Queen Bee, but she...
Hey, don't you dare.
She had a long past.
And I'll fight you about Beyonce.
I would just like to say that the views on the No Filter Friday show are the views and the opinions of the host, not of the IBNX Radio Network.
And this I own IBNX Radio Networks. Why are you lying?
Yeho.
Why are you lying, though? No, I'm just kidding.
Yeho talking, and I am hot.
It is not Pueblo.
It
I will tell you this if I was not drinking.
I love Beyonce. Let me
say this. I was grown when all this happened.
So you understood a little bit more.
Yes. Then ninth grade Tippy.
Now ninth grade Tippy was getting it in. Now don't get it mistaken.
Getting it in and understanding.
I was understanding a lot of things.
That motherfucker be taking people out.
Mm-hmm.
Those two different levels.
I was taking motherfuckers out then.
No, not that kind of taking them out.
Oh, okay.
Because we cursed. She put us on mute. We said, mob.
I was taking a lot of women out.
Mob.
I forgot who said that. One of the comedians.
Ernest J.
Ernest J.
His brother.
I was thinking about that earlier today when I was
because
I was in traffic. I was behind somebody. I was about like, motherfucker, go.
And no, we're not saying the F word. For the record, even though she's muting us.
But there's No Filter Fridays. How you get muted on No Filter Friday?
Wait, I be telling her, like, you stop.
Fridays.
No, it should be called Fridays. Some Filter Fridays.
Kind of a filter.
Two Filter Fridays.
Pop Filter Fridays.
Occasional Filter Fridays. Wow. Okay, so Pueblo is in rotation.
Right.
You starting to feel a little warm and toasty.
I'm hot. These bright ass lights.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, these lights bright, man. I know. And next time we come from break, they're going to see me in the blue t-shirt with a big ass H on the front.
Sign up for his OnlyFans.
Premium.
Premium content.
I take it off right now. Hit that donation button.
$5 to sign up for the month.
$10
if you want beyond the month.
I was $5 last year. You feel me?
Excuse me. $10 for the month of February. It goes up to $15 in March.
We got a promo code Pueblo. Get $2 off. It'll be $8. But
OnlyFans.com.
Only one.
All right. take a quick break from the nonsense right here on No Filter Fridays on IBNXRadio.com.
You know everybody been waiting on that baby, man. I mean it like ever since baby on baby drop, man.
Ever since baby
you
on
know,
baby
drop, ain't nobody drop shit. Let's go, ha. I needed some shit with some bop in it. I flew past the whip with that blunt in my mouth, watch it swerving, that whip had a cop in it. My bitch got good pussy, fly her across the country. I finished the show and I hop in it. I got me a milli, I did it legitly. I'm still with the shits, I'm a hot nigga. Oh, you asking for pictures with niggas? What's your name? Get the fuck out the spot, nigga. Tryna figure which deal I'ma take. I woke up, couple meal on my plate.
Let's eat.
I'm investing in real estate. I just went and gave my mama a 100. Probably won't hit me open my mouth, bless you hearing me talking about finding some money.
Let's go.
As soon as I found that, I flipped that.
Flip.
I'm a little bit different, they get that dick.
No, I'm stiff on the bitch and she dig.
Tryna find out why baby ain't all in the mentions. No, she ain't get no DM from me.
Bitch,
this rich nigga dick, it ain't free. She be throwing that ass, yeah, she good at it. Turn around when we fuck, make her look at it. She like, ha. I needed some shit with some bop in it.
Let's go.
I flew past the whip with that blunt in my mouth, watched it swerving, that whip had a cop in it.
Hey.
My bitch got good pussy, fly her across the country. I finished the show and I hop in it.
Yeah.
I got me a milli, I did it legitly. I'm still with the shits, I'm a hot nigga. I'm unorthodox than a motherfucker. Hey, when you gon' switch the flow? I thought you never asked. Niggas ain't fucking with me and ain't about what the fuck they be rapping about with. They look scary ass. But to each his own, nigga. If you like it, I love it. No big,
no fee.
That boy say he get money.
Oh, really?
How much they just cut you a check for?
A milli.
I'm going back to Cali like big.
Go back.
About to go get a pound just to smoke.
I smoke.
They told me to come work on my album. I'm trying to go find out the price on the boat.
Okay.
My little bitch act like Megan Thee Stallion. She get her with nasty. She driving the boat.
Drive the boat.
All this shit that they making be boring.
Let me something to bop while I ride with the pole.
Here you go.
Okay.
I needed some shit with some bop in
it.
I flew past the whip with that blunt in my mouth. Watch it swerving. That whip had a cop in it.
Woo.
My bitch got good pussy. Fly her across the country. I finished the show and I hop in it. I got me a milli. I did it legitly. I'm still with the shits. I'm a hot nigga.
I'm hot.
Like this shit for like, you know, the sophisticated ratchet hoe, you know. The ones that go to work by day, then, you know, dance in the mirror by night.
Ha! I needed some shit with some bop in it.
Okay, let's go.
I flew past the whip with that blunt in my mouth, watched it swerving, that whip had a cop in it.
Woo.
My bitch got good pussy, fly her across the country. I finished the show and I hop in it. I got me a milli, I did it legitly. I'm still with the shits, I'm a hot nigga.
Hot.
Oh, you asking for pictures with niggas?
What's your name?
Get the fuck out the spot, nigga. Trying to figure which deal I'ma take.
Uh-huh.
I woke up, couple meal on my plate.
You can catch me in the cherry red 150.
Ooh.
Got the grizzly locked in the stizzy.
Yeah.
Pop the glizzy, doing 60 down a one whizzy. Drunk pissy, trying to cruise through the avenue while my people just popping bottles up in sewers. Rendezvous, fuck that. Spun the UE, lost the hubcap, was back to the shack. Came back in a what's that? Straight from Paris, Jacob Gabby's days, baby cabbage, Terry Gallus.
Nice.
Bird, cherry radish, fresh out the dealer.
Yeah.
Got the check for the squealers, wear a vest for the killers.
Yeah.
Nothing that's cause it's realer in the Big Apple. Where it's quick to get the shit tackled. Enemies spit at your best friends, kidnapped, you trust no one. Got beef, buzz, yogurt,
yeah.
You don't need no one.
Nope.
Talking about that you owe him, I'ma go for Dolo. Scarface with a vanola, one deep, probably solo, but he throwing bolos.
It's hard work, baby. I just lost 100 pounds. I'm trying to live. I ain't going nowhere.
Be like
I'm staying alive,
but they
baby.
Don't bust their guns, and it's so hard.
That's my wife. I pay for them titties. Get your own dong, you heard?
Niggas wanna fuck my wife. Niggas wanna take my life. But it's so hard.
Wanna with the squad. We like guards. Catch us at the bar, the bar, the bar.
Yeah.
The strip bars in Miami. Almost came home with the Grammy. Next year, bring your home three for the family. Watch me. You can catch a live on Hitachi. Popping shit like a Nazi. Iced out like DiBiase. Fuck that, Liberace. 4X Versace. Somebody stop me. Never that. Where my niggas at? Uptown, uptown. You know you're feeling that cash rule. Hardcore, you can dance to. That old Biggie, give me
one more chance.
Take a glance and I'm off with yours. With both hands and off my drawers and jerk me like the Source Awards. I love hip hop. I ain't even probably the best there is since alive. Tell the squad, nigga, stop sleeping.
Yeah.
What you say your name once again? And I know you from where?
Elementary school.
Chickens wanna be like
I don't know you,
but
man.
They know so hard.
That's you again. Go that way.
Niggas wanna fuck my wife. Niggas wanna take my life. But it's so hard.
Ooh, yeah.
taking my
No filter Fridays. They filter me anyways.
It's so hard.
I don't want the filters.
Yeah.
I want to say what I want. All right. We are back. You're listening to No Filter Fridays right here on IBNXRadio.com with Tiny Pun.
Nah, that is not Donnell Jones, ladies. That was me. Holla. Only one tippy. Yes, he got the vocals, too.
So, first of all,
I'm singing on Valentine's Day all day for $50.
Let's be very clear that that was not Donnell Jones on that song in the first place. So,
that
nobody
was Donnell Jones. Oh.
On that song?
Yes, mine.
Are you sure?
Yeah, mine.
Oh, I'm thinking about I Don't Want to Be a Player No More, Joe. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, I'll let you slide.
That's why I said they thought it was Donnell Jones.
I know you know, I Donnell was my dude.
And I sound just like him. I don't care.
No.
I don't care.
No.
I don't care.
No, I don't. I sound better. Okay. Okay.
Sing Dangerously in Love right now.
I don't like that song. I don't even know the words.
That's one of the best love songs ever made.
But I will sing Get Me Bodied.
Nah, that's too fast. Sing Halo.
I don't know the words.
Oh, my God. I know you know Bills, Bills, Bills.
Of course.
Oh, my God. See, guys, see, fellas, this is why we come back February 15th. This is why.
First of all, single, free, and disengaged, and I am available to be your Valentine's date if that's what you need. I have a variety of Valentine's packages available. Follow me on Facebook if you'd like more information.
And I'm just singing and laying down for $50. You get a 2-for-1 package. I sing to you, then I take you into the bedroom and put it on you.
I ain't giving it up for $50.
Me and Pueblo.
$50.
$25 security.
$50,
deposit.
All you can do is post pictures of me on your Facebook or your Instagram.
I need a security deposit. Listen, man, I'm not high strung. I understand. It's tax time. People haven't got their taxes back yet. You have to give some people a break.
First
of all,
that's
why it's $50 now. But when tax hit, it's $250.
Let's be very clear. I'm a female, so most dudes are not waiting for their tax money. They're waiting for somebody else's tax money. Uh-huh. So the dudes that would spend the money for me to be their Valentine already either have money.
Right.
Or they don't. And if they don't, then I will not be.
Got you. You got somebody to flip your taxes for you? I got you. You give me $1,000, I'll bring you back $3.
I could flip my own taxes.
I got you, though.
They call They call me Bird Girl.
See, but you don't even know what I'm doing, though. You don't even know what I'm doing with the money. You don't know what I'm doing,
but
though.
But I be flipping them.
Me and Pueblo going to hit them spots. We're going to gamble.
No.
We're going to gamble.
Not my tax money.
I got you.
No.
Ladies.
Don't fall for it, ladies.
$25.
First of all, I already told him he got some crap on his shirt.
This is my little brother's school. You know what I'm saying?
It's got a Patriot on it. It's some crap.
Yeah, this is my little brother's shirt. I ain't even from the front with y'all. I got on my little brother's shirt right now, man. I slept over there and, you know.
Front. I thought that's what you said. I thought you said I ain't going front.
I don't know. Pueblo talking. Who said that? I just heard Tippy.
Wait, did he say the F word? Oh.
I did?
Whoops.
Oh, I don't give a freak. This
I
is my
thought
brother's
you said
shirt.
I ain't gonna front.
I don't know what I said.
Pueblo said.
I ain't gonna lie to you. I don't even know what I be saying half the time. Drunk, sober, anything. It just comes out. Come out like diarrhea.
So, I'm gonna dock the boat. So, you see?
We're gonna
you
dock
see?
It right here.
You see?
We're gonna dock
this
it right
is what happens.
We're gonna dock it next to the dock.
I take a couple of sips, and I'm still the voice
she
of reason.
She's trying to take the boat to the deep end. You can't dock it in the middle of the ocean. You got to dock it.
No, I was docking
right
it.
Here. No. This is the dock.
No. Because what's going to happen is no,
the ocean.
You're going to be like trying to have dockside boat parties.
Well, how about this? He ain't on the dock. He in the garage. We put him in the garage.
How much y'all want to bet? He going to be driving the boat in a minute.
Yeah, I'm going to pour you some again. You want some more?
I have some in my cup.
Which you're not drinking.
I am. Look.
I don't see no wings on your back. You're supposed to have wings and a Spanish accent.
So first of all, I was really about to say,
Why you think I'm supposed to have wings? Rappers does not give me wings.
You're supposed to have wings in the Spanish
No,
accent.
They don't work for me.
You're supposed to, hey, papi. Papi.
First of all, if my voice ever got that deep, hey, papi. Sounded like Speedy Gonzalez. Arriba, arriba, andale, andale.
That's how you need to drink this bottle. Arriba, arriba, andale.
First of all,
if they say so.
I am the designated driver.
For who?
For myself.
Oh. Man, they got Lyfts and Uber. Y'all be safe when y'all out there drinking. Catch your Lyft, catch your Uber.
I'm not Ubering nowhere and then having an Uber back to get my car the next day.
You can sleep in the car.
I have been down that road.
You can sleep in the car.
Did I? Oh, my God. That happened to me one time.
You slept in your car?
I've done that several times.
I said, yeah. Not unwillingly.
Young me.
Unwillingly.
Young me. No. One time I went. It was my homeboy's birthday. Mm-hmm. And I'm a person that believes when it's my friend's birthday, they shouldn't spend any money. We should go.
I can say that, right?
You can say
shit.
That. So we should go shit. Have a good time. And the birthday person is not supposed to spend a dollar. So we go. It's me, him, and one of his homeboys. And we get like a VIP section.
You know it's my birthday today, right? It's my
birthday. How is everybody's damn birthday here at the station?
I'm going to be like, Giselle, you know today my birthday. You going to give me a drink, Craig? What today is?
And I'm going to tell you like old boy's daddy when... Debo asked him, did he want some too?
No. It is my birthday though.
It is not your... I almost said the F word. You about to get me in trouble. So look. So I ended up... We had the VIP. It's three of us on like two or three bottles.
Okay.
Three.
More than enough liquor.
Too much liquor.
Right.
All I know is... We leave the club. I got my homeboy's white jacket on me.
You already fucked up.
It's got... I'm sitting on the curb like this in the fetal position. And I hear... And he's going to get his car. Because at this point, I can't even drive my car.
Yeah.
So he's going to take me home.
So he was drunk.
I was drunk. Sitting on the curb in the fetal position. Drunk. And I hear girls walking by saying, Po thing, where her friends? So my homeboy come, he put me in the car. Thank God for homeboys that like respect me and care about me and ain't finna do nothing.
Shout.
So he drove me home, dropped me off, and then the next day, one of my homegirls took me to pick my truck up from the club.
Well, let me tell you about my club experience in Miami. I went out with a few of my cousins, and we went to this club called Rolex. If anybody from Miami, y'all know about Rolex.
We know about Rolex.
Yeah, so now I think
I'll be working it's at Rolex Climax. When I go to Miami. I was just working at Rolex for the Super Bowl.
What was you doing? You know what? I'm not even going to ask you. It's called Climax.
Who told
it's
you?
Climax,
who, ma'am.
So, me and my cousin, we went to Climax.
Some of these people who listen and don't know that. Can I live?
The ones in Miami know.
I was just at the Stripper Bowl. I was working at the Stripper Bowl. I made my $750 like everybody else.
And I was the nigga stealing out of the Stripper Bowl.
Back to what you were saying.
So, yeah, I went to Climax Rolex one night with my cousin. She got me, I think they got slip and slides there. Then we went
was
to.
Was the 69 boys there?
Nah. But the next club we went to, Trick was in there. And Trick was like right next to me turning up. We had fun, but I was so drunk, I just couldn't do nothing. No, that was another night. But we ended up going to Coco's, and I think they got Scarface. Either they got Slip and Slide or Scarface, but the drink is so sweet.
Mm-hmm.
You wouldn't even think no alcohol. Man, I was laid out.
Those are the best drinks. Club.
No, it is not.
Mixed drinks that
was laid.
You can't tell the liquor is in it is the best.
Man, I was fried that night.
I bet.
I was outside the club throwing up next to a bum. He looking at me like, nigga, don't get that shit on me. A homeless man.
Now, that's the one thing I didn't...
He looking at me like, don't get that
when
shit
when the homeless
me.
Man like,
no, you supposed to be helping me.
He like, no.
Pat my back or something, nigga.
Get your ass away from me.
Hold my hood.
Get the fuck away from me.
Yeah, it was embarrassing.
You know, now since home. She has said don't say it, I like want to toy with the word. Get the fuck away from me.
That's probably what he said, too. And I'm sorry, Mr. Man. Sorry for throwing up on your shoes.
It
your
is so hot in here.
But it was horrible. What that mean? Drinks. Drink some more Pueblo? Oh, she said drink some more. Okay. All right. Engineer's telling me drink some more.
Oh, my God.
I did not say that.
Dry the boat. Oh, you said get to the segment. I thought we was going back to this segment.
I can't. Okay. So, it's now time for one of my favorite segments.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, y'all.
That's what's up.
That's what's up. All
and right. That's where we talk about something positive in the news, in the media, that kind of stuff. All right. Tippy.
Okay.
Hey, Tippy.
Yes.
Hey, Tippy. Are you ready?
Yeah.
That's what's up.
Yeah, yeah.
I just made that up, y'all. I'll never ever do that again.
That might be a new segment intro.
Hell nah.
But my first, that's what's up, even though it's kind of, well, it's good news, but I want to give a shout out, birthday shout out to the people who were born today. First and foremost, I want to give a major, major 33rd birthday shout out to Miss Sandra Bland.
That's what's
up. Rest in peace. Today is her birthday. Also, Garth Brooks, don't front on the legend.
That's what's up.
Steve Nash.
That's what's up.
Former NBA player. He was dope. Ashton Kutcher.
That's what's up.
Everybody in the industry. And Chris Rock.
That's what's up.
Legend. You know what I'm saying? So them the birthdays I have today.
Okay.
And you give me one, I'm going to give you one back. We're going to count it. So what's your that's what's up?
So my first that's what's up is the Kobe tribute that's coming up at the Staples Center on February 24th. I think that's super dope. And yes. So I think that's what's up. I also like that the first Lakers game after he passed, everybody who attended got a jersey.
And did the 24-second violation.
Yes.
On all the games, how they took the 24-second violations, each team. That was dope, too.
Yeah.
Just the tributes, period, was dope.
Exactly.
How they showed Kobe love from lighting up buildings to
And I'm going to say this. I was never a Kobe fan. I always felt like he was very arrogant, and I did.
I respected his game, though.
But that's what I was about to say, but I couldn't deny his
greatness.
His greatness.
Right.
As you know, an NBA player and his philanthropy and that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. He was, to me, I still think he was an arrogant asshole. However.
On the court.
On the court, yes.
You're supposed to be.
Yeah, but.
That's your feel. Like,
no.
You gotta own it.
No.
You gotta own it.
No. No.
Because one thing about it, when you put that much work in to be great.
No, but you also have to remember that you're on a team. And there were a lot of times where that boy wouldn't share. You know that.
What team? What team?
There was no team? You going to play Shaq like that?
Yes.
How dare you?
Now, well, okay, Shaq was dope, but what team? Okay, so.
You know what?
Towards the end of his career, what team?
You know what?
All right, ladies and gentlemen.
You got another that's what's up?
What? What? This the best one.
No, I think my next one's the best one, but go ahead.
No, this one is the best one. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, cats and dogs, Red Lobster is now giving out Cheddar Bay biscuits in a heart box. Yes, if you get half a dozen biscuits, you add a dollar more for the box. But you could deliver the Cheddar Bay biscuits to your bay in a heart box that says Cheddar Bay, and you can write their name on it. I'm going to order me like 5 of them and send them to myself.
I was about to say, you sending them to the 5 hoes from the family cookout?
Oh, hell no. Nah. Hoes don't get no Cheddar Bay biscuits. What? Bitch, you get Popeye choke. How about that? How about that? How about that?
Why the hoes can't get the Cheddar Bay biscuit?
How about that? You get Pueblo and Popeye's biscuits.
Wow.
You don't get no Cheddar Bay biscuits. Cheddar Bay is for bay.
You are
Cheddar Bay is for bay.
Hard on these hoes.
Cheddar Bay is for bay.
That's what that H stand for? Hard on these hoes?
Hard on these hoes. I'm a hoe. I'm sending them to myself. I'm bae to myself. I'm my own Valentine.
Okay.
Ladies, I ain't got now. Inbox me, and I'll send you a box.
Don't nobody believe you.
I don't believe myself.
I got to see if cuz still on there calling you out. She better not be.
But anyway, Red Lobster, Cheddar Bay biscuits, half a dozen, you get 6. Add a dollar more, you get the box. You can put your name on it.
All right, so what's your next that's what's up? Because I know you got another one.
All right. So, my next that's what's up.
And the reason I want you to do your next one is because my next one goes into TSBS. So.
Okay. So, my next that's what's up is saluting the NASA astronaut, Christina Koch.
Why do you have to say her name like that?
Hold on. Wait. K-O-C-H.
Christina Koch.
K-O-C-H. What does that say? K-O-C-H. What's that?
Koch.
Koch. It's not what I said.
Cock.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry, Christina Koch.
Christine. He said, wait. He said, Christina Cock.
I'm just, hey. I'm just, hey.
How old are you? Like five?
I'm a.
Oh, really?
Okay. NASA astronaut. Let's do this again. NASA astronaut Christina Koch is back on Earth after an 11th month space journey, breaking the record. Christina Koch broke the record for the longest single space journey by a female. So shout out to you, Christina Koch. I didn't even know that she was even in space, and she landed somewhere in, somewhere on Earth. I didn't even know she was in space. So you gotta let us know when you leave, okay? So we know when to praise you. Because if you wouldn't have came back, we wouldn't have known shit. So I'm just saying, let us know in advance. Send out a tweet saying, "I'll be right back in 11 months." That's all I'm saying. So that shout out to Christina Koch. She just made history. What?
Timmy.
Yo, this is going to be a soundbite for the rest of our life. We need not to do this. This need to be professional.
Timmy.
Charlamagne going to give me donkey of the day. And you over here crying.
This might be the funniest. He said, I didn't know you was up there.
I did it.
So sis, you got to let us know.
You got to say something.
Because if you had come back.
How we going to know?
Oh, my God.
No. But think about it, though. I'm reading the news. I'm like, she got back from 11 months. I didn't even know she was up there. So Christina Koch sent out a tweet, text me, email, something, okay?
First of all, she ain't sending you shit after you call her Christina Koch.
Christina Koch.
She was done with you once you said, Christina Koch.
Y'all know I got a little, I ain't got my glasses on.
You got a little Pueblo in you.
I ain't got my glasses on, got a little Pueblo. You know what I'm saying? Got wings on my back. And Christina Koch looked like a little cock. So I'm sorry. Shout out to you, though. You made history, baby. We love you.
I can't breathe.
We love
you. It's making my stomach hurt.
We love you.
What's your tea? I should have ate those french fries.
What's your that's what's up. She over here crying, y'all.
Okay. So my last that's what's up is actually part of a TSBS.
Okay.
And for those who don't know, the TSBS is that's some bullshit. And that's where we talk about things that are some bullshit that we'd have heard about in the media.
Right.
So I got to start with a TSBS and then say my last that's what's up. Because okay. It was in response to the TSBS. So my TSBS goes to former Auntie Gail. And that
former
bullshit.
Auntie Gail.
Yeah, she ain't invited to the cookout no more.
Yep, she got to stand on the other side of the gate with me, huh? Yep, Gail.
No, she gonna be over there with the hole that you taking a plate to.
The Tupperware bowls. I ain't bringing it to the cookout.
You are not bringing no bowls. You better take a styrofoam
either
plate.
Bowls or holes. Which one you want me to bring?
No.
Bowls or holes.
You gonna take a styrofoam plate with some aluminum foil on it. And that's the best we could give you. You could flip two plates on top of each other and put the foil around the whole package. But you not taking no bowls.
Bowls or holes.
Bring the holes. You gonna be embarrassed.
Okay.
You and that hoe gonna be embarrassed, and you gonna wish you hadn't.
I'm gonna bring her. She ain't gonna embarrass me.
See?
Be
See?
The best hoe you can.
You know that. What? I'm not. So, former Auntie Gail got out of pocket, just like her and her old homegirl, and those who can see me.
We're gonna call her Sophia.
Homegirl, Sophia. You know, they always, I don't understand it because, you know, I just feel like in the world we have enough people tearing us down, particularly black males. And it's like you can't be accused of anything and ever get past it and move the fuck on.
Right.
I wanted to say it, but I couldn't say it. But you know what I meant. And at the end of the day, Auntie Gail need her black ass whooped. And I would never normally disrespect Auntie Gail, former Auntie Gail. But this some bullshit. This dude just passed. And you bringing up allegations from 17 years ago, of which he was acquitted.
And the thing that bothers me is she's saying it was tasteless. They took out the clip. But you, that wasn't literally pieced together second by second. That was
right.
A conversation that was had. And they decided to take that soundbite and make it you know, clickbait, but it's the fact that it happened. You
right.
said that.
If you hadn't said the shit,
nowhere in the interview.
If you hadn't said the shit, they wouldn't have been able to take nothing and clip it.
Right.
Problem solved. Don't say the dumb shit.
Right.
And they can't clip it.
And she got a hold of that. Just like I was listening to, I think it was Ricky Smiley we was listening to. He was saying, think about how Vanessa feel.
Right.
F your feelings. What about how Vanessa feel?
Oh,
how
but there's the kids no thought to that. Because what she thought was, so here's the thing about Auntie Gail. Auntie Gail right now is doing sensational interviews and that kind of stuff. And she saw how people rallied behind her after she went after Uncle Robert. Now, here's
that's
the thing.
Uncle, ain't my uncle.
That's your uncle.
No, he pissed on his nieces. No.
He did not piss on his nieces.
Yes, he did.
He pissed on Sparkle's niece. Two different things. She wasn't related to him.
Oh, even worse. Co-working niece. That's like, you know, I ain't even going to
Sparkle brought her there.
Yeah, but just because you bring your niece, I ain't finna just pull my pants down and piss on her.
But if you know a nigga piss on bitches, why would you leave your niece with him? Why would you even bring your niece?
Nigga probably had to pee then. Nigga said, hey, I pissed earlier.
No.
I ain't got no water.
No,
I'm good.
No. First of all, let's just be very clear about that whole situation. First of all, Sparkle's husband knew who R. Kelly was and what he was about. He took his wife to the studio trying to do music with R. Kelly. Then when the bitch never came back home, now he all of his feelings angry about it.
Wow.
Continue on. Sparkle know who the hell R. Kelly was because he had already pissed on you, if you really want to be honest about it, which is why you left your damn husband when you started working with R. Kelly, but that's a whole nother story. And then now you bring your niece and you just leaving her in the studio with him? This nigga got a damn bed in the studio. What did you think he was doing? You know what he did to you in the bed and every other young chick that came through there? What you thought he was going to do to your niece?
Whole pissy family. Whole family just pissed off now. Pissed on and pissed off.
Exactly.
That is disgusting.
Exactly. But everybody was defending, was on Auntie Gail's side when she did that to Uncle R. And rightfully so. You know he that uncle that always used to entertain all the kids, but he done did some embarrassing shit, so you don't really want to claim him. He really ain't an uncle. He like a distant. He married into the family, but he really still your uncle. You still be listening to his music. You still be making babies and doing all that shit you was doing in the 90s to his shit.
Just don't piss on the babies.
Oh, God. Anyways, that being said, she thought that saying this about Kobe was going to have the same reaction. And it was a miscalculation, and it was disgusting because right. The man has not even been dead a month, a couple of weeks.
He's not even buried yet.
So I don't even, I'm wondering if they can even bury him, though, which is a whole nother story. But right. At the end of the day, that leads to my that's what's up, because Uncle Snoop, see, this is why family got to stick together and defend and say what they need to say and check people. Because Uncle Snoop spoke up and cussed her the hell out, and he should have because she was wrong. And that's the one thing Uncle Snoop said. Uncle Snoop was like, listen, I ain't one for the disrespect and all of that, but her and her homegirl, Sophia, want to dog all these black men, but ain't said shit about Harvey Weinstein. Where's the interview on that? Where's the documentary on that? Y'all want to dog poor Michael Jackson after he's dead with false allegations that have never been proven. You want to dog out Kobe with allegations that he's been found not guilty of after he's dead. You got Harvey Weinstein alive and kicking and ain't said a damn thing about him.
Right. And it's sickening. You right. And it seems like we are being attacked as black men. But
you black?
I am part Mexican right now because of Pueblo. But you know, it sucks
right.
That, you know, we are attacked like that by those, you know, prominent figures because they have a voice in the culture.
Right.
Not just in the culture, actually in the world, because they do have a white audience as well. So,
which makes it more irresponsible that, right. That she did what she did. And that's why I like what Snoop said, which is essentially she's speaking for those she's choosing to speak for. So he's going to speak up for the rest of us who don't agree, don't like it, but don't have the platform or the voice to say something.
So all I got to say is Auntie Gail or former Auntie Gail, stay out of Publix. Just stay out the streets right now.
You can't come to the cookouts.
You hot. Niggas are trying to jump you.
Can't.
So, shout out to you for fucking up. Oh, I messed up. Okay, TSBS, mine.
Yes.
I love my black people. You understand?
Right.
I love black people.
Okay.
But I hate niggas.
Where are you going with this?
So, we have a news report from WRAL, Raleigh, North Carolina. And we're going to break this down once it's, you know, I'm going to play the sound bite and we're going to dive into it more. But that's some bullshit.
Okay.
What is going on and, you know, how is this impacting you? Has water gotten into your apartment or anything yet?
Well, not yet because it's not that bad, but over here on this side it kind of is. And I guess in the far back it is. That's why the cars is up here and stuff. But it haven't really hit our parking lot yet, so it really ain't affecting me yet. But once it do hit that, they probably going to tell us to evaporate and then that's what gets on my nerves. We got to keep evaporating.
Yeah. And I know we're right by Bowling Creek and you said that this happens a lot, that you all have flooding here?
Yes. When I first moved here, I think the first time I moved here, it was like this. So we had to, like, evaporate. And it had, like, boats and stuff out here because the whole thing was, like, flooded.
Well, I hope this gets resolved quickly. Thank you so much for talking to us. And we will see what is going on and, you know, how...
So let me just start by saying that newscaster need her ass whooped.
Right. I was just thinking that.
Because she had an opportunity to say, you know, well, hopefully they won't evacuate you. And she just let this dumb girl evaporate.
No, she should have just said, back to you, Bob. That's it. Just cut off because you know where she going with it.
No, you should have corrected her for any other person who might be listening that doesn't realize that that's incorrect. I would have been like... Yeah, hopefully they won't evacuate you.
Right. Well, ma'am, whoever's in Raleigh, North Carolina, I know all of y'all don't talk like that. But for a young lady.
We just get evaporated over and over. We done been evaporated like 3 times since we moved here. And horrible. I'm just tired of evaporating. That's some bullshit for real.
Her vocabulary has it. And I don't have the best vocabulary myself. But I know evacuate from evaporate. So let's just get that right. That's some bullshit, baby girl. You wrong. And we're going to get you hooked on phonics. Duolingo, all that. We're going to teach you proper English.
But the water ain't hit the parking lot. How is it in the house?
She just dumb all around.
It was in the parking lot, but it evaporated. Duh.
That whole interview should have been evaporated. In my next, Oh, he's on you?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead, because I got a good one. It's sad, but I got a good one.
Oh, well, dude, we definitely got to do my next, because you can have me all crying
and
stuff.
It's not sad, but it's you going to come with a conspiracy, I know it, but go ahead.
You already know me. Mine is that President Trump has been found not guilty by the Senate and will not be taken out of office. So he will be remaining in office, and that for sure
is some bullshit.
It's some bullshit.
Now, was not some, well.
I'm not surprised, but that's some bullshit.
Just to tack on a little, that's what's up. We really don't know about voting, the judicial system, the government, you know, branches. We know, but we don't know the inner workings of it. So shout out to the Shade Room. They posted this young man named Yellow Pain. He got a song called My Vote Don't Count. And, man, when I went and listened to the actual song, it broke down to us what we're missing as people, what we need to be voting for, who we need to be voting for, what we need to be focused on. So shout out to him. If we listen to that song, we learn more. Maybe Donald Trump won't win the next election. It might be Bernie Sanders or Andrew Yang. So, I want Andrew Yang. He giving out free money.
So here's the thing.
Mo Pueblo.
I can't. So first of all, potentially it could impact the election. But that song, definitely for those who haven't listened to it, talks about the fact that we all run out and vote for a presidential election, but that's not really the election that really even damn matters. Mm-hmm. The president doesn't make the laws. You got to get out and vote for those elections in between the presidential elections. Impact the Senate and the Congress and make sure you have the right people in the House. And, you know, so get out and vote every 2 years when the time comes. Your local elections are important. And that's the point dude is making. Like, stop being stupid.
Facts. And it was a dope record. So, you know, Donald Trump, you're not going to hope. Do you think he's going to win the next election? Be honest.
Man.
We don't want him there, but do you think he's really going to win?
Right now, I don't feel like there's any one standout Democratic candidate, and I think that's what's going to hurt the Democratic Party. Nah.
Andrew Yang?
Nah.
Oh, man. Damn. I'm going to run. Y'all vote for me. Fuck it.
So I got another... I don't know if this is a TSBS or a That's What's Up.
You need to drop a clue bomb every time we say the F word. Like one of the flex clue bombs. Every time we say the F word, you drop the F bomb.
I've never said the F word in my life.
Fucking liar. So.
Did you hear him?
I whispered. You ready for the next one? You got another one?
Well, I don't know if it's a TSBS or a That's What's Up.
Well, what it say? We'll categorize it.
So, one of R. Kelly's former captives has now gotten free.
TSBS. TSBS.
And is living her best life.
TSBS.
She's all over Instagram.
With the BS.
Yes, thotting it up.
Making songs.
Singing, making songs, but thotting it up in the same time. Because she's her boobs all out. And
for real? I ain't see that post. What's
you got to go look at her. I ain't telling you. She's named after the cat from the Smurfs.
I don't see.
Gargamel's cat.
I don't even know how to spell that. Okay, so baby girl, just sit down somewhere. Stop making music. I saw her eating a bowl of fruit in the studio. That's good.
No, that's she's on this weird fruit only diet.
That's all she eats?
For the next 30 days, bless you. That's what she says she's doing. Fruit only. And people are like, why? Like, you're small.
I haven't seen her. I don't even know. Is that the girl that got in a fight with the other girl?
Yes.
Recently?
Yes. Because remember, the two girls did the interview with Gail, with Auntie Gail.
She was one of the girls? Yes. Because I never saw that. Yes. I never saw the...
And she put on her Instagram story, what if I told you that I have R. Kelly on tape telling me what to say for that interview?
He was free?
Yeah, he was free when they did that. No, he wasn't. So I don't know
they
where she.
They called him at a McDonald's parking lot, didn't they?
Yeah.
Getting Happy Meals. So funny
for them, yes.
He was getting them Happy Meals for her?
Yeah, and he would have made it away, but she told me she wanted to switch her prize out, so he had went back to switch her prize, and then that's how they got
it. Nah, with Scooby-Doo now. They pulled up on him in the mystery van. You darn kids, I would have got away with it if it wasn't for you.
No, he said that to the girls. If it wasn't for you darn kids wanting different Happy Meal toys, I would have got away.
Disgusting. So... Enough about R. Kelly, who is not my uncle. Her uncle.
That is your uncle. No, he was at the last cookout.
No, he wasn't at mine.
Yes, he was.
No, sir.
I got the photo of you and him together.
Nigga, put that key in the ignition and get the out of here. How about that? Listen, R. Kelly is a musical genius, but I have a daughter. And it's sad because he got a daughter, so he should know better.
He has one daughter and now another son.
You got a son?
The daughter transitioned.
No, she did not.
Yes, she did.
You lying.
I'm serious.
When?
She's been transitioned a couple years now.
What? What's her name? Andrea Kelly, his ex-wife's daughter?
Yes.
She got what I got?
I don't know if she got the full surgery, but she identifies as male now, yes.
Oh, man, this world is coming to an end. All right, in the morning news...
Did you say in the morning news?
In the morning news. There's some TSBS.
Okay.
The Chinese doctor. Damn right. So, the Chinese doctor who broke the news on the coronavirus has died from the illness. His name was Li.
Corona.
Wenling. Probably said that wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Died at Wuhan. I probably said that wrong. Central Hospital. I said that right.
So here's the interesting thing about that.
Ain't nothing interesting about it. They killed that man. They killed him.
No, but did you know the coronavirus has been around since the 60s?
No.
Yes.
I didn't even know there was a coronavirus. I just know about Coronas, Heineken's, Michelob Ultra, and I don't drink none of that. I think that's probably where it came from. Probably came from that Corona.
The coronavirus has been around since the 60s. That's where...
In China?
In the U.S.
It's been here since the 60s. So they mean it got to be in the CDC then, which is here in Atlanta.
Yes. And so they had a death in like Colorado or something like that back in the 60s. And recently there was a death in Chicago. But if you look at like your, like the Lysol wipes.
It says protect from coronavirus, right? What is a coronavirus though?
It's some kind of like virus, like a flu virus or something like that, that is airborne that you can catch.
And that's why I do not drink beer. It's too much.
It has nothing to do with beer.
It says corona. Coronavirus.
That virus was around. Name Heineken. Excuse me. That virus was around before the corona beer Corona's was found.
Been around since.
I don't know. Google it. Google.
1886.
That's Pueblo.
They cousins. Same family.
So that just mean they was Mexican. Born the same year?
Yes. Duh.
No. Stop making shit up. Because somebody somewhere listening is like, dang, that Tippy is just smart.
Man, listen. The no, he's making shit only up. One Tippy is dumb as hell. Do not believe anything that come out my mouth.
He's making it up, y'all. He does not know when.
Nah, but seriously, though.
See, the corona was found in 1925.
I wasn't that far off. I said 1886.
Well, I guess it was before the virus, because the virus was in the 60s. Well.
It came from the corona drink. No you know more. How they put the little worms in the bottom of some of these tequilas?
It's the lime, just like in that beer salt.
Nah.
I'm telling you, it's the lime. Just like in the beer salt.
So.
Coronavirus.
Rest in peace to that doctor.
In the beer salt.
Do you think he was killed? Because he's the one that broke. Well, how can you break the news on something that's been around since 1960?
They're calling it the new coronavirus.
What?
Yeah, they're calling it the 2019 coronavirus. So if you Google coronavirus, you'll see coronavirus, and then you'll what also did you see
get in 1960.
Then you'll see cold, like, it was something different. So this is supposedly a new strand of it, and they call it the 2019 coronavirus.
They treat viruses so you like could, weed now.
Yeah, you could.
Hey, my nigga, I got that strong, hey, bro. I got that
2019 corona.
I got that corona, hey, bro. Let me get five of those.
No, I want the 1960 corona. Man, I ain't got that, hey, but bro, I got that 2019.
Hey, my nigga, let me get a seven of that corona.
See?
Coronavirus.
So yeah, so they are calling it the 2019 corona.
Because it's a new strand.
Yes. And so apparently I think he found the new strand.
And he died from it.
First of all, if he died from it, somebody injected him.
Of course.
I'm pretty sure if he discovered it, he was protecting himself.
Is it an airborne virus?
It is. Like,
oh, okay, so you sit next to me, I could get the coronavirus.
Right.
And you sit next to me, you could get the Pueblo virus.
Which probably I already have because you've been pouring it in my drink.
Right. Right.
Driving boats and all that.
No, I drink. Look at this. That's a whole shot gone.
That's more than a shot. First of all, it's right here. I drank most of that. It was up here.
I drank most of that.
So you see?
I'm good.
That much gone. I'm the designated driver. I'm not drinking.
But shout out to him. Shout out to Dr. Lee. Winlane.
But it's just like how they killed Dr. Sebi.
Yeah, they definitely killed him. I believe that. But I mean, I don't know.
But you know, there's a school of thought that Kobe was murdered.
And you know what's crazy? I was on TMZ earlier today looking up stories. Mm-hmm. And there's actually a story on TMZ right now. You know TMZ is reputable, so y'all get off my balls.
Actually, they're not, because TMZ said, first of all, let's be very clear. TMZ said four people died in that flight.
They break the news first. I ain't going to say reputable, but they break the news first.
Right, but that doesn't mean they're always right. They are definitely wrong a lot of the time. But
all
right,
so here we go.
Wait, listen. So, first of all, they have footage of the flight going down, and it's not typical engine failure footage or sounds or any of that. So that's number one.
Right.
But then number two, there is a video, a cartoon from 2017 of Kobe being in a helicopter crash.
See, that's one thing I don't like. People are so nasty. I don't believe that was done in 2017.
It was.
Because now people could really make, unless the dates on the videos
it
is, date back.
No, it really was made in 2017.
And
like,
who did that?
It was a whatever that cartoon was that used to come on back then, but it was made in 2017, and Kobe goes down in the helicopter crash, and they tell him, pass me the trophies. Mm. And he's like, and they said, and then we'll save you. And he's like, no. And so people are saying how it's ironic that he died in a helicopter crash a day after his record went to LeBron.
Right.
As if he passed the trophy, you know. But then there's also the discussion about the fact that Kobe was involved in some legal battles over the name Black Mamba.
With the pharmaceutical company?
Correct. And he was currently trying to trademark Mambacita for his daughter. And so, you know, unless Vanessa keeps it up, those lawsuits are going to die with him.
Right.
And then we may see some pharmaceutical company coming out with Black Mamba, whatever.
Man, I see y'all come out with Black Mamba. We're going to be outside y'all building. Don't play with Kobe. So what I seen on TMZ today, the NTSB says an initial investigation into Kobe Bryant's helicopter crash shows no outward evidence of engine failure.
Which is probably true. First of all, the fact that, number one, Kobe Bryant was a millionaire, had an amazing helicopter. Why the hell they flying in this old-ass 1991 helicopter instead of his regular helicopter?
That wasn't his regular helicopter?
It was not. That's number one. Number two, they're talking about the black box had been traded out for an iPad. When have you ever heard of a plane not having the black box? Then you have this seasoned pilot going out on a on a foggy day. Really? 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 Really?
So professional, sorry.
It's like he just started pouring in the middle of the show.
It's Pueblo. It's Pueblo. It's okay. It's Pueblo.
Then if you think about the fact that they had grounded all flights that day, how the hell they got clearance to go? The police were grounded that day. All celebrities were grounded that day. Like, nobody had clearance. How Kobe got clearance in this old-ass plane that doesn't have the necessary updated equipment, a 1991 plane, when he had a new plane.
I don't know. It just bothers my soul. We lost a legend. And it makes me think about life a lot, you know.
What bothers me most about it, I don't like the whole, like, getting rid of people and killing people off, but I know people do it and they get away with it. But the fact that you would do it with fucking children, excuse my language, children on the plane, that's some ill shit, man. And there's a special place in hell for anybody who was involved in that.
Oh yeah, it's messed up.
And that's real talk.
Yeah, anybody that come out with a Black Mamba, I don't give a damn, this is a toy. We at you. Don't play with Kobe. Don't play with him. Y'all seen what happened to Gail? Former Auntie Gail.
Who is no longer invited to the cookout.
Along with myself.
And R. Kelly.
Yeah, I ain't going to be standing next to him on the other side of the fence. That nigga going to be sitting in his car. On his plate.
You know good and well he going to be at the cookout singing Step in the Name of Love.
No, he can step his ass out.
He gonna be there. Step in the name of love.
So I got a question, because to me this is kind of like some TSBS.
Okay.
What do you think about the Meek Mill and Nicki Minaj situation with them airing each other out online? That, you know, that store, that situation happened in the store where, you know, they ran into the husband. Things got kind of crazy, and now they're airing each other out.
I think Nicki is a businesswoman, and the whole online battle that came after that is a strategic move. Because she got music.
And Meek planned it, or she did it?
I think the run-in just happened, and it was what it was. But I think the continuing of the online dragon and all of that was strategic because she got new music out. Because she just happened to drop a song now.
Which I like that thing. I listened to that thing about 4 times today. That Yikes.
Yeah.
It go hard.
Yeah.
I don't know who she talking about.
Meek.
I don't know.
Yeah.
But she went hard. She went in. Got to get a queen her credit, man. She went in on that one. She really did.
There's only one queen. 2 queens.
Beyonce and Lil' Kim?
Thank you.
Okay.
She's a Lil' Kim copy.
But she's still dope, though. Got to give her credit.
She's not the queen, though. No, she don't. Safari used to write a lot of her stuff.
Well. Shout out to Nicki Minaj, her new song, Yikes. Dope. I love it.
And we're going to hear it.
Can we hear that? What?
She said over. It's over.
Since when?
What time is it?
It's over?
No, she didn't. No, you didn't.
The show's over? Since when? What time is it? Oh, 10:53.
We started late, though.
When the show ended? I seen nobody was watching.
We're still on live. What are you talking about?
Yeah?
Yes. I got people watching on mine. They in my watch party. They just not in yours.
But we done?
We still on live right now.
Oh, so she lied.
She's saying she's playing Yikes on the way out. Well, clearly, Tippy has checked out because Pueblo is kicking in. You've listened to No Filter Fridays right here on IBNXRadio.com. We are back unprepared and no filter.
Y'all on.
So we'll see you next Friday. Same time, same bat channel. Tippy, say goodbye.
Same bottle of liquor. Shout out to Pueblo, my uncle.
We will not be drinking Pueblo
and
next week.
By the time I come back, I will learn the electric slide, at least a quarter of it. Okay?
Yes. No Filter Fridays, IBNXRadio.com. Peace.
God bless y'all. We love y'all.
He be like, yikes. What's the hype? This is something light. Yikes. Out of town, on consistent flights. Yikes. Work hard, just a different way. Get your life. You just ain't living right. Yeah. I keep 2-9 here. You see my face all over that Fendi design gear. Soon as request you, boy, you throw up peace sign gear. Yeah. You don't want that action, pull your card, you decline gear. Yeah. I keep 2 dimes here. Yeah. Walk up to a bat, be like, I think you fine here. Yeah. I don't play with demons, Satan, get thee behind gear. Yeah. About to give up a margarita with 2 limes. Yeah. I've been the same, ain't she changed? This ain't nothing new. That pretty frame, diamond chain, what the fuck it do? Yo, clear the way, it's some bad bitches coming through. I give 2 F's like the letters that are on my shoe.
IBNX Radio.